Now we are discussing about the wave function. What is the meaning of wave function? A function means it is a mathematical expression which describes the motion of the wave through any medium. Such like that, let us suppose take a string which is fixed at one end, free at another end. Suppose if we apply the force like this, like a perpendicular, then it creates the crest and troughs in it. Then the diagram will change like this. This diagram shows the wave pattern along the string which is fixed at one end and which is free at another end. Now like this it will start. After some time interval, it is the position. After some time interval, that means what we can expect from this graph is the wave pattern is moving towards the obstacle or the fixed position. Whenever the wave pattern, which was arises due to the disturbance along the string, is moving from one end to the another end, it is associated with many physical quantities. One is amplitude, second one is displacement, third one position, velocity, time, and many more physical quantities that are dependent on these five. So such like this, if you want to describe the motion of the wave pattern along the string, it should be associated with these physical quantities. Whenever these physical quantities were expressed in a mathematical form to describe the motion of a wave is called wave function. The wave function is called as, or the wave function is defined as, a mathematical expression which describes the motion of wave pattern involving the x, v, t and many more. Is called a wave function. It is defined as a mathematical expression which describes the motion of a wave pattern involving x, v and t. So function, the symbol is f. That means the mathematical expression of this function is described as in terms of f. Let us suppose if the wave is started like this. Then we can eliminate this. What is the position coordinates of this wave? It is t is equal to 0. At t is equal to 0, automatically v is also 0. This is moving towards the forward direction. If suppose the motion has started from the second end and moving towards the origin, then these two cases will be expressed in a mathematical form like this. F is equal to f of x plus or minus vt. So the equation we have written is f of x plus or minus vt. Here this f is the function which describes the displacement of the wave along the string. So such like that, one wave loop is created on the string and we will see the initial and final positions of this. Here it is t is equal to 0. At the same time, v is also 0. So the perpendicular displacement is also called amplitude. This is the initial position of the wave. This is the final position of the wave in a half cycle. So the wave is traveling towards right or towards the end point. In this case, this f will become y. What is this y? Displacement. Now we are expressing the displacement of the sound wave as a function of position, velocity, time. Here it is the plus or minus coordinate, but here I wrote minus. What is the reason? The wave is traveling to right. So then what is the need to express with minus coordinate? Because when a wave is traveling towards the right, its amplitude continuously decreases because wave always travels from the high range to the low range. But whenever this was moved in the opposite direction like this, so here also we can expect t is equal to 0 and v is equal to 0. And in this case, the displacement of the wave is expressed as y is equal to f of x plus vt. The wave is traveling to left. So this is said to be function. Which function? Wave function. So here the wave function is representing with position, velocity, time. So x is position of the wave. V is velocity of the wave. T is time period of the wave. Mostly all the waves are periodic in nature. Otherwise, they won't propagate to the longer distances with same equal amplitude and some fixed displacement. So we will check how the periodicity will work to express the wave nature or to express the equation of the wave along the strings. So the subclassified form of the wave function, the another type is periodic wave function. What is periodicity? Repeating the motion in the same path after the fixed time interval is called periodic wave function, means a periodic path. So periodicity. So periodicity means repeating, continuous repetitions of by fixing the time intervals. So a wave or waveform repeats itself in fixed time intervals. Is called periodic wave function, or is called a periodic wave. So in this case, what we can expect is, this is the waveform. Continued. So these loops, these up peaks and only up peaks we are observing. These up peaks were created or formed after the fixed time intervals. The time interval between these two and these two and these two are same. So if the time interval is not fixed, of course a waveform is repeating itself. It is not said to be a periodic wave function. So in this case, the distance, we can say this as lambda, because the lambda wavelength is defined as crest to crest or trough to trough, or successive distance with the distance between two successive compressions or rarefactions. In this case, here to here, the peak to peak distance is called lambda. In other words, means we are expressing this wave function in terms of velocity and time also. Therefore, we can write v into t. The same v into t is repeated here also, and here also. So, if we wrote a function which is useful to describe the displacement of the wave and that to be a periodic wave, it is written like this. Y of x comma t is equal to f of x plus or minus vt. So this x is position, t is time, is a representation of f of x plus or minus vt. So the same path of the wave is repeated after some time. So let us say the time is repeated some time is at a distance of lambda, but the fixed path between the up peak and up peak of the two successive crests or trough is equal to lambda, or we can write it as n lambda, because lambda, next 2 lambda, 3 lambda, it is continued in form of n's. So now this position of the wave is keep on adding with a factor of n lambda in periodicity. Therefore, the same path of the same path is repeated after n lambda distance. So therefore, the equation of periodicity can be written like this: y of x plus n lambda of comma t is equal to f of x plus or minus vt. Suppose if the distance is changed to n lambda plus n lambda plus n lambda, what about the time? Time is also keep on changing. So here, in this case, we have mentioned the change in the distance with periodic function, and in the next case we should write the change in periodic function with time. So therefore, it is written like this: y of x comma t plus mt is equal to f of x plus or minus vt. So here t was also changed. So because of the change in this time and change in this position with the factor of lambda and mt, where m is, m and n are integers, then the function will be f of x plus or minus omega vt or r omega t. So like this, we can define the periodic wave functions in case of sound waves. The another classification in this case is harmonic wave function. All periodic motions are harmonic, but all harmonic motions are not periodic. So in this case, what we can understand is harmonicity means if a particle is vibrating to and fro from a mean position, all particles are in connectivity with each other. Means no particle is out of phase when the body is vibrating. Such type of motion is called harmonic motion. So harmonicity is represented with a sine function or cosine function, because all particles may be parallel to the reference frame or perpendicular to the reference frame. So therefore, y of x t is represented by a sine 2 pi by lambda into vt minus x plus phi naught. Here a sine 2 pi by lambda is a propagation constant. It is also represented by k, like a sin kx minus omega t, like that. So you can write this one as a cosine function also. Therefore y of x t is equal to a cos again 2 pi by lambda into vt minus x plus phi naught. What we can understand from these expressions, where a is amplitude of the wave, v is velocity of the wave, t is time period of the wave, x is position of the wave, phi naught is initial phase of the wave. These all are the physical quantities that were used to express the describing the motion of the wave along the string or along any other solid medium. So this is a function progressive. And one more thing what we can say is, we can express this displacement with respect to the periodicity in position and time. Now we will check harmonic wave functions are periodic. There are two ways to show as periodic. One is according to the position, another one is according to the time. First, we will check the position periodicity. Periodicity in position. Initial position of the particle or nothing but the wave is x. Whenever it is periodic, then we should add this one, or we should add x as a case of x plus lambda, because lambda is the periodic function to observe the wave function in this case. So the general equation is written like this: y of x comma t is equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda into vt minus x plus phi naught. So what we can understand is, this x is repeated at the position of the particle, is repeated after the time interval, some time interval, and at that point this periodic function becomes x plus lambda. So after the lambda distance, the path repeats. So what we can understand from this, therefore y of x plus lambda comma t is equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda into vt minus x plus lambda plus phi naught. Now this will be a sine 2 pi by lambda into Vt minus x minus 2 pi by lambda into lambda plus phi naught, because we did the expansion. Here this lambda and lambda gets cancelled. So let us suppose sine 2 pi plus or minus theta. So we can say that sine of theta plus or minus 2 pi is nothing but sine theta. So after the 2 pi time period, or after the 2 pi angle, the path repeats itself. Therefore, in place of all this, we can write sine theta. Therefore, y of x plus lambda comma t is equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda into vt minus x plus phi naught. So harmonic wave functions are periodic in position. Next we will check it is periodic or not in time. Now we will check the periodicity of harmonic wave functions in time. Periodicity of harmonic functions in time. That means if length extended to x to x plus lambda, automatically time will also change. T plus t, t plus 2t, t plus nt or mt. So length changes from x to x plus n lambda, time also changes from t plus nt, where n is integer. So already we have proven that the position coordinate is periodic in harmonic function. Now we will see the corresponding time is a periodic or not. So the general expression for this is y is e of x comma t is equal to f of, or we can write a sine 2 pi by lambda into vt minus x plus phi naught. And one more thing, here we are not observing the position periodicity in time. Therefore, y of x comma t plus capital T is equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda into v of t plus capital T minus x plus phi naught. So therefore, it is a sine 2 pi by lambda into vt plus 2 pi by lambda into capital T minus 2 pi by lambda into x plus phi naught. We did simple expansion of the form. So we will get 2 pi by lambda, Vt is lambda gets cancelled, and it is time, and here also it is x. So therefore, a sine 2 pi by lambda into lambda plus 2 pi by lambda into t minus 2 pi by lambda into x plus phi naught. So in this case, what we can write is y of x comma t plus t is equal to, this lambda and lambda gets cancelled, this is 2 pi by lambda into t, this is x. So therefore, it was nothing but vt minus x. So
a sine 2 pi by lambda, we can write x as vt plus phi naught. Again we got the same equation. So what we can understand is, in time also harmonic functions are periodic in nature.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.